Hey guys, it's Chris. From forts that were made with techniques that shouldn't have been possible, to items that defy scientific convention and more, join me as I reveal 8 incredible finds science can't really explain. Number 8. Vitrified forts of Europe. If you learned that a great many cities and kingdoms in Europe had forts sitting on top of hills, you probably wouldn't be that surprised. We all know that Europe was a land throughout history that had battles of various sizes and scales. Thus, having a fort would be great for reconnaissance, defensive fortification, and so on. But over the course of many years, these forts of the past have re-emerged and caused a bit of confusion because they're vitrified. Vitrification, in simple terms, is the process of turning a certain kind of hard object into glass, and to do so requires a very high heat. When it comes to these forts, the walls were literally fused with glass. Now, this should be impossible given the time periods they were built in. Another mysterious aspect here is that these forts are truly all over Europe and have various sizes that indicate that this process was indeed done by many people over a great period of time, and not just one technique used by all. Many of these forts can be found in Scotland, yet how the Scots or anyone was able to not just produce the heat needed for this process, but how they were able to do it in massive walls is still a mystery. Number 7. The use of obsidian. History has shown that throughout the world, there are many different materials that cultures use to build things, and sometimes it wasn't easy to get the work done, and yet they did it. But for many Native American cultures, as well as cultures of what is now Central America, they seem to have an extreme fondness for a particular substance, obsidian. Obsidian is a kind of volcanic glass that can be shaped into various things, if you know what you're doing. Which is where the mystery comes in. Because despite obsidian being a very brittle substance that at times can be near impossible to work with, they did it. And what's more, they did it repeatedly. Whether it be in South America or the people of Mesoamerica, it didn't matter. They were able to create tools, weapons, and most importantly, sculptures. Some of these obsidian sculptures are shown off in museums today, including ones of monkey vases, perfectly cylindrical discs, and more. Focusing beyond the use of obsidian, one also has to wonder how they were able to make the obsidian so perfectly shaped. Modern tools could do this work, but not without extreme precision. And obviously, they didn't have that. So how were they able to craft them so perfectly, so beautifully, and without error? It seems like there must have been some type of ancient technique that's been lost over time, but that allowed these civilizations to craft incredible tools and art without modern technology. What do you think? Do they have some advancement that was lost when the European powers conquered the New World? Let me know your opinions in the comments below. And while you're at it, don't forget to hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. There's loads of incredible videos being published all the time, and you don't want to miss out on any of them. Number 6. Baghdad batteries. There are many objects found in archaeological digs that resemble modern-day construction, and they boggle the minds of those who try and interpret how they could have been made thousands of years before. One example is a site in what was Mesopotamia, now Iraq, where an ancient form of battery appeared to be found. These are known as the Baghdad batteries. The jars that contained the battery elements were of terracotta, but the insides contained a copper rod and a spike, as well as asphalt cork at the top. But before it was sealed, the battery was said to be filled with an acidic liquid. Most believed it was either lemon or grape juice. The result was something that could indeed produce an electric charge, which is something that definitely would have shocked people when it was first created. Pun intended. The batteries were believed to have been built between 250 BC and 250 AD, which was obviously many centuries and even a few millennia before they should have been able to be constructed, depending on when they were made. Of course, given that the charge was indeed small, what were they made for? Weirdly enough, the mystery grew to such heights that it went on to the series Mythbusters, where they tried to figure it out. Electroplating, acupuncture via the use of electric jolts to ease pain like in some modern practices, and as a religious experience, were found plausible as possible uses. But the catch was that a singular battery didn't have enough juice to really do much of anything. But put enough of them together and you did get results. Which may have been why there were so many found together. But how did someone from that time period come up with this series of items to put them together and make a battery? The whole thing kind of surprises me. What could they have done with them? Were there indeed ancient engineers building batteries 2,000 years ago? Let me know what you think. Write a comment below with your ideas. Number 5. The Cthulhu Tablet. Take a look at this object right here. So what's the first thing that goes through your mind as you look at this tablet? If you're familiar with this cultural reference, you probably think that the squid head at the top is a reference to the H.P. Lovecraft being known simply as Cthulhu. According to Lovecraftian lore, Cthulhu is an ancient god that lives in an underwater city, and he is known to not just be extremely powerful, but also as a being that can apparently drive people insane if they merely hear his voice or look at his face. Believe it or not, despite being from a story by Lovecraft, the being Cthulhu has taken on a life of its own, actually being worshipped by some and many believing he's real. This is why the tablet that was found is so interesting. This clay tablet is believed to have been found off the coast of the United States, which would track with the underwater city that the god is supposed to inhabit according to the legend. However, there are many who feel this tablet is fake, and even if it were real, it doesn't mean that it's referencing Cthulhu. Now, it could, absolutely, but it could also be referencing another pantheon, or just made to scare those who looked upon it. Likely, we'll never know the truth. Number 4. Nazca Lines. In Peru, there are a series of geoglyphs known as the Nazca Lines, and their size and detail are one of the greatest mysteries in the world today. These can continue to be talked about because of their mysterious nature, one that you can only truly appreciate from a certain point of view. Of course, when you're on the ground, you'll see nothing but lines in the dirt, but when you're high up, you'll see that these lines take the shape of animals, humans of sorts, and much more. Thus is revealed the mystery of the Nazca Lines, mainly why and how. The accuracy of these lines, whose estimated creation is put between 1 and 700 AD, is kind of mind-boggling, and yet the whole project is far too advanced to have been done in that time period. Yet that didn't stop them from not just making one, but several of these incredible figures. There's one line that goes 9 miles in length, and it's perfectly straight. Of course, as researchers can tell you, due to the technology at the time, this was only done via basic tools and with the human eye. As for the Y element of the mystery, some say they're symbols of their gods, and some say they're prisons for monsters or signals to beings in the sky. But the true truth in terms of the purpose of the lines are within the minds of the Nazca, who are long gone from this world. Yet that doesn't stop many from trying to figure out the mystery, because it is something that truly gets people wondering how the ancients were capable of such feats. Just as interesting though, just 25 miles away from the classic Nazca lines are another set of geoglyphs put into nearby hills and mountains, and they're just as intricate and just as mysterious. Some people believe that these are the results of alien civilizations interacting with ancient humans, but the truth is up for debate. Number 3. Desert Glass. In December of 1932, a man named Patrick Clayton, who worked for the Egyptian Geological Survey, was driving through the Sahara Desert near Libya, and he heard something that didn't make sense. For despite driving on sand, he heard a crunching sound, so he stopped the car and looked under his tires to find that there was glass underneath them. And not ordinary glass, mind you, but pure glass. Glass with a yellow-green tint, and one that apparently had iridium in it. This would eventually be dubbed Libyan Desert Glass, and is the purest natural silica glass ever found on Earth. But the mystery that was on everyone's mind was how this glass was formed in the Sahara Desert. After all, while it is true that sand can be turned into glass, an enormous amount of heat is required to do the process. What's more, the Sahara Desert itself cannot produce such heat on its own, enhancing the mystery. The most popular belief in regard to the glass's creation was that around 20 million years ago, a massive meteor hit the Sahara, and the intense heat caused the glass to be made. Of course, scientists showed that this theory could work if the conditions were right. The only problem that they presented was that the meteor in question wasn't found, and there's no proof that it was indeed made this way. The Libyan Desert Glass is considered one of the most beautiful natural glasses in the world due to its yellow-green color, and it kind of makes one wonder if there are other glass deposits like this out there in the world. Number 2. Giant's Bones? While simplistic, giants are a key part of the fantasy world. From mythologies to the Bible to Harry Potter and other fantasy series, the ideas of men and women as tall as buildings have long been a part of our legends and lore. Of course, what makes them a mystery in some cases is the rumors and indecision of whether or not they were truly real. As we all know, humanity does have a natural inclination to exaggerate. But there is some potential for truth about giants, as we have seen through actual human heights. The Guinness World Record for the tallest man ever is Robert Wadlow, who was 8 feet 11 inches tall. Wadlow was tall, no doubt, but giants are said to be significantly taller. And that brings us to arguably the biggest piece of evidence for giants, a cave in Nevada where findings of giant bones were supposedly discovered. The bones themselves were found by an archaeologist, and according to them, they didn't just find one set of bones for a giant, but several, a whole burial ground's worth. What's more, tests for the bones showed they apparently dated back to prehistoric times. Should these findings be credible, it would paint a much more interesting and unique picture of human evolution, as it would show that just like many animal species, humanity decided to shrink instead of grow even larger. But what evolutionary pressures could have pushed us to get smaller? Perhaps it was prehistoric giants who are to blame for so many ancient mysteries and unexplained archaeological discoveries. Number 1. Black granite sarcophagus. Finding a sarcophagus in Egypt is nothing new. However, in 2018, a very curious kind of sarcophagus was found in Alexandria. What set this one apart was that unlike most burial sarcophagi associated with Egypt, this one was pure black granite and had no markings on it that would indicate who or what was inside. This is, of course, a stark contrast in how Egyptian burials are usually done in regard to grand fanfare and exquisite luxury. The look of the granite sarcophagus caused many to be wary of it. Some even felt it might be cursed due to its jet black coloring. As mysterious as its look, though, is that it was buried 16 feet below the ground, and it wasn't alone in the spot it was found. Sometime after being discovered, archaeologists from Egypt's Ministry of Antiquities opened the sarcophagus, and they found three bodies inside. One of them was a male, and two were women. And while this answered one question, it raised many more, including why these three were in the coffin, why they were put in such a coffin, and why they were buried so deep. With more of these coffins being found, there are many mysteries to solve here, and you have to wonder if they'll ever truly get solved. Thanks for watching. What did you think of this look at mysterious finds of the world and how science can't explain them? Which of them do you feel is the most mysterious? Let me know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe to World List, and I'll see you next time on the channel.